students. I'm Sarika Ahuja, your math teacher from Bright Scholar Senior Secondary School, Sonipat. So far, you have learned how to solve a pair of linear equations in two variables by the method of substitution and elimination. Here I introduce one more method to solve a pair of linear equations in two variables, that is cross multiplication method. Let's start and have a look. First, let us obtain the two equations to solve it by the method of cross multiplication. And the two equations are 2x plus y is equal to 5 and 3x plus 2y is equal to 8. Now, let us take 5 to the left hand side. Here you can see the sign of 5 is positive, and when it will go to the left hand side, the sign will become negative. So the equation will become 2x plus y minus 5 is equal to 0. Similarly, we are going to take 8 also on the left hand side. 3x plus 2y minus 8 is equal to 0. Let us compare these two equations with the general form of the equations which I told you in my first video, that is a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. Here it is very easy for you to compare the two equations and find out a1, b1 and c1. So you can see the a1 is, your a1 is 2, b1 is a coefficient of y, so b1 is 1 and c1 is minus 5. Same way a2 is 3, b2 is 2 and c2 is minus 8. To memorize the method of cross multiplication method for solving linear equation in two variables, the following diagram is very helpful, and please look at, I have written x, y and 1, and what I am writing, that is b1, b2, c1, c2, a1, a2 and b1, b2. What is a1, b1, c1, c2? That is, a1 is the coefficient of x, b1 is the coefficient of x and c1 is a constant term. Let us insert the values x, y and 1. B1 and b2. Your b1 is 1 and b2 is 2. C1 and c2. Your c1 is minus 5 and c2 is minus 8. A1 is 2 and A2 is 3 and B1 and B2 1 again, that is 1 and 2. Now, I am going to put, you can see these arrows. Now, what does these arrows indicate? The arrows between the two numbers indicate that they are to be multiplied and the second product is to be subtracted from the first. I repeat my words once again. The arrows between the two numbers indicate that they are to be multiplied and then the second product is to be subtracted from the first. So just see how I am going to do, that is x. Now, I have told you multiply, 1 multiply by minus 8, that is minus 8. As I told, that the second product is to be subtracted from the first, so the second product is to be subtracted, that's why I put a sign of subtraction, and the second product is minus 5 multiply by 2, that is minus 10. In the same way, you can do the next one also. Minus 5 multiply by 3, that is equal to minus 15. And 2 multiply by minus 8, that is minus 16. In the very same way, 2 multiply by 2 is equal to 4 minus 1 multiply by 3 is equal to 3. Let us solve it. X minus 8 minus into minus plus. We are absolutely right. Plus 10 is equal to minus 15 minus into minus again plus 16. 1. 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. Minus 8 plus 10 is equal to 2. Minus 15 plus 16 is equal to 1. 1 upon 1. As we are solving these two linear equations by the method of cross multiplication, and we need to find out the value of x and y. So my next step is that I am going to equate x upon 2 with the constant term, that is 1 upon 1. Similarly, to find out the value of y, I'm going to equate y upon 1 with 1 upon 1. Let us do the cross multiplication once again. Both the sides, x multiplied by 1 is equal to x, and 2 multiplied by 1 is equal to 2. Similarly, y multiplied by 1 is equal to y, and 1 multiplied by 1 is equal to 1. So here we have find out the value of x and y by the method of cross multiplication pattern. I hope you understand. If you feel any query, you can ask me on my WhatsApp number. So your homework is to solve exercise 3.5 by the method of cross multiplication method. Thank you.